How many of y'all are going to let the Holy Spirit talk in you tonight? We yield, he'll show us some things. He always, he'll show you some things if you yield. You got to know how to yield to him. You got to know how, I thought that was the Holy Ghost. I was finna jump. I told them boys the story of the other day. It was in a meeting. Man wanted to move with the Holy Ghost so bad he heard some people laughing. And they thought they was in the spirit, but they were laughing out in the flesh. A man was sitting behind a lady and his leg was so long, every time he tried to sit down right, he'd bump her in the back and they would start laughing. And the minister thought they had a Holy Ghost move going on. Want to move bad, boy. Anything moving, we'll take it as a move, you know. She liked to slip down and say, that's the Holy Ghost. Get a move going on. Father, we thank you so much for what you've done for us this week. All the fellowship you've let us have among ourselves, we thank you so much. And your presence been in our midst. You've been protecting us and providing for us and empowering us. And we thank you so much. We thank you so much for Jesus. What a price you paid that we can assemble here and move in authority and dominion. We thank you for the Holy Spirit that teaches and reminds and give us understanding, give us wisdom. This very night we yield to him and we yield to all the work you've done, the blood of Jesus, and we yield to the word of God. We need rapasata. And we yield to understanding and wisdom and discernment and knowledge. So bless every person on the sound of my voice here in the auditorium and around the world. We have had 4 days. This is the last day of this camp meeting this year. We've been blessed, Lord. And so we just thank you. Thank you for the fellowship, the relationships, all the things that transpired. We thank you so much. In Jesus' name, amen. You may be seated. Grab your Bible and go back to Hebrews 2. Hebrews chapter 2. Get there as quick as you can. There's a lot of things I have to say to you. I'm going back to that fourth verse. But tonight we're going from a different angle. Matter of fact, we want to expose your spirit to the fact that signs, wonders, divers, miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost is not ill will to wealth. And they have studied the gifts of the Spirit and studied signs, wonders, and miracles. And many of the provisions that Jesus made, that was a word of wisdom, a word of knowledge, special faith. Jesus was actually, many times when he did supernatural provision, he was operating in the gifts of the Spirit. Many signs and wonders and divers miracles that you read in the gospel, the Lord Jesus was operating in the gift. I wouldn't see why he wouldn't operate in the gift over finances, because finances is part of the gospel. So I want you to make note of this, that signs, wonders, divers, miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost in your finances. Signs, this one's gonna get you out. Wonders, divers, miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost in your finances. In your finances. The gifts of the Spirit works in your finances. You can have a word of wisdom in your finances, a word of knowledge. You can have discernment in your finances that beyond this world. All right. Verse 4. Hebrews 2:4. It says, God also bearing them witness. Now, that word witness is very important here as I'm going to aim the yield to the Holy Spirit to open some things up. But the word witness is important, and the end word, God's will. God witness through prosperity, through abundance, God shows signs and wonders through finances, just like he showed for a miracle in your body. All right, now, God also bearing them witness both with signs and wonders and with divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost according to his own will. Now, the Spirit of God in preparing said to me, when I walk in my office this afternoon, about a little after six, he said, the body of Christ has not known the operation of supernatural finance. Anybody here want to know? The body of Christ has not known the operation of supernatural finances. Why? Tell me how many books you read or how many sermons you heard that they brought the signs and wonders and divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost in operating in finances. See? And you got to hear this too, because this is a hindrance. Because most believers think it's unspiritual to be financially prosperous. Misread the Bible. And it is mostly ministers' fault. Because they won't learn and manifest that they may teach the truth, knowing that God is their source. Too many ministers have made people their source. So they can't be a mouthpiece for God because they're trying to chip through the tulips. And the woman said, man, just tell me the truth. You don't have to go all around. Just tell me the truth. I'm trying to get my little child out of problem. I don't want no soft coming for an offering. Tell me what God's saying now, so I can get my miracle. Tell me what I'm doing wrong. Just bear with me. You must pass the money test properly before you can go to the next level. And then, see, that's level jam. People have got themselves in levels jam trying to go too fast where they see somebody else at. All right? Now, money shortage is not the problem. Going after money, not trusting God as your source, is the problem. And are trying to arrive at a level you're not ready for. I'll read that one over. Money shortage is not the problem. Going after money, not trusting God as your source, is the problem. And then and add on to it, and trying to arrive at a level you're not ready for. You haven't passed the money test yet. Now, let's look at a few things and that I think can open up the corridors of heaven for you tonight. These scriptures are familiar, but I think I need to go over them before I dive into showing you Boaz and how Naomi had the gift of prophecy. And she prophesied Boaz and that girl's life. Come on. Yes, sir. How in 2 Chronicles, we'll go to them, how that five armies was against this man. Yes, sir. And they actually didn't know it was a setup for a wealth transfer. And so we'll look at some of these things in a few moments. Then there in 1 Kings, Elijah and his widow at Zarephath, supernatural provision. Then the other woman, husband had died. And since she didn't have nothing, but the man of God had a word for her. So it's so sweet. It's so much sweetness here that I believe it will alleviate you of some of your problem tonight. You can hear one word I say. You don't have to hear the whole teaching. There's a word in my mouth for you tonight. And don't you let your trifling neighbor who's sitting next to you make you miss your word, act like they know so much and they broke. Some people don't want to listen, you know. They act like they're all that. They sit up there and they won't say amen. They won't nod their head, just looking at you like, you know. That ain't going to happen up in here. Let me see your checking account. You don't want to listen to me? So let's go over a few scriptures that, turn to Psalm 23. I got to go over a few scriptures before I get into Psalm 23. I mean, you know, hallelujah. Now, I'm trying to stay calm on purpose, you understand? Yeah, I want to do some teaching tonight, and I won't get your money. Yeah. In Psalm 23, the Holy Spirit brought me to this passage. He said, now I want you to read four or five things to them. They know all, but I want you to remind them of them. In Psalm 23, verse 5. And I just want to deal with my cup running over. Yes, sir. Why your cup is not running over? How long you been in church? Here he says, my cup runneth over. You think that's the only cup God run over? So with signs and wonders and divers miracles and gifts of the Holy Ghost, you could begin to manifest and see demonstration of these things in your life as a witness to the will of God. As a witness to the will of God. All right, now, my cup runs over. Now notice, we read Malachi 3:10. I just want to use the term not enough room to receive. Where is this at? Where is this stuff? Why would God put this in the Bible? We're going to have to pray for finance the rest of our life. Tell somebody it's time for your cup to run over. How many tithers do we have in the house? Tithers. How many of them have been tithing for a long time? Now you know that's wrong. Let me talk to you up in here. You know that's wrong. It's wrong. You've been tithing all the time. You've been tithing 10, 15, 20 years and still got money problem. Something wrong. Yeah, something wrong. We got to find this out. We got the Holy Ghost got to help us with this. Good people tithing and living good life. Not living sinful life, but just tithing and tithing and tithing and tithing and tithing. What is the deal where there's not enough room to receive? I won't finally get to that, you know. I won't finally get to the place where I don't have enough room to receive. I don't just want tithe. Some of y'all been tithing 15, 20 years. Still got financial problems. Something wrong. What are you going to do with Luke 6:38? Good measure, pressed down, shaking together, running over. And boy, we got songs about it. We sing it. We dance it. When you gonna start spending it? So that's why I want to drop you down in this gift. I don't know how the Holy Spirit is gonna do this. I want to drop you down that a manifestation can come in this room and an anointing can get up on you and you can wear it as a cloak. And it'll begin happening in your life, not just saying it. But it began to clear things up for you. Amen. Can I get an amen here?
Amen.
How many of y'all ready for your manifestation?
Amen.
I'm just tired, tithing and tithing and tithing. I know I'm supposed to tithe, but God dog, I must be needing to know something else. Amen. Are you following me?
Amen.
Then when we go to the text in 2 Chronicles 20, 25, it's make the statement more than they could carry away. Then in 2 Corinthians 9:8, it talks about having all sufficiency. Where is this stuff? In the body of Christ. At large, you understand? High percentage wise. Some of y'all may have some money, but it ain't the money you're supposed to have. Now, I want to go some places here. Go to John chapter 6. John's Gospel, chapter 6. And we'll see Jesus working in a word of wisdom and a word of knowledge, the gifts of faith and the working of miracles. You think Jesus just fed them fish? Multiply by just faith? No, listen, let's look at this. Let's look at this for a minute. Yeah, let's look at this for a minute. Because it's time for you to have some sign and wonder. You see, we got to get away from check consciousness. You know that check, I've had check consciousness. And you know that check don't, it just won't do it. And so you have to know if you're going to get to your wealthy place, you're going to have out of the ordinary manifestation. Yes. Y'all believe this? Yes. And so tithing and sowing and giving activate another realm. Yes, but you have to know how to flow with it. Yes, are you following me? Now here in John Gospel chapter 6 for a few minutes. Yes, sir. Verse 1. After these things, Jesus went over the Sea of Galilee, which is the Sea of Tiberias, and a great multitude followed him. Now look why they followed him. Because they saw his miracles, which he did on them that were diseased. Now everybody shout about that. No, I'm saying it sarcastically. Yeah, everybody shout about that disease miracle. And they sort of leave miracles in that category. But no, in this chapter we got another miracle. And it's not about disease, it's about provision. See, we got another miracle here. They're following because of the miracle of disease. And Jesus said, now I got to show them another miracle. I got to show them another side of my supernatural flow. So you got to see it. You got to see it. You just can't sing and shout. You got to see it. There's a supernatural financial flow that God wants you to tap in. What I say? Write that down. Because I don't want you to forget that. There's a supernatural flow of finances that God have made available for you to tap in. The church didn't tell you. And the church couldn't tell you what they don't know. They're so busy with collections and budget and offering. Can you help my ministry? Preach 20 men, beg 2 hours. Verse 3, and Jesus went up into a mountain, and there he sat with his disciples. Passover, a feast of the Jews was now. Verse 5, when Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company coming to him, he said unto Philip, can we do this naturally? You are not going to overcome this financial system naturally. You're going to have to come to the wisdom of how to yield to the movement of God. Are you listening to me? Now, you're not listening at a secondhand preaching, you understand? I'm preaching what I have done. From zero, I don't know. Are you following me? Now, remember I told you one word from God. I'm kind of tiptoeing through here. I'm taking my time. But we saw a disease miracle. And many of Jesus' miracles with disease and sickness, the gifts of the Spirit were there. Signs and wonders and divers miracles took place. You know, there's one of the gifts in the power here called the working of miracles. All right. Now, in the fifth verse, then when Jesus lifted his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, they came unto him. So, oh my, I see a revelation. I see a revelation. When you come to him, he takes responsibility. So Jesus tonight make himself responsible for your finances. Now, if you don't get that, the next thing I'm going to say, you're not going to be able to get it. You see, when you come to him, he become your source. If he can get your eyes from looking somewhere else. Trying to make a deal and all this multi-marketing they brought in the church and these pyramid and telephone and girlers and all kind of stuff and sanitary napkin and all kind of stuff. Bringing up in God's house trying to sell something and get something going on and have a downline and people selling it. And one girl said she wore the thing with her white suit on, the sanitary napkin didn't work. Gonna bring all this stuff from God's church. Some of them join the church and they sit still for 2 or 3 years, but they're working the people all the time. The church is not made to make a deal. Jesus took a whip and drove them out, said, look, no dealing in here. This gospel got to be preached up in here. You got to go out there in the secular world and make a deal, but you can't make no deal up in here. And so all this stuff get in the church and the people fall for it because they're not seeing no results. How many markets you been in? I know whole churches, men lost their church. That thing come in the church and tore it up. I had the Amway people come. They came and stayed here for years. But I kept telling them, Jesus said, I am the way. I wouldn't let them get off of me. Then I had my people trained. My people know I raised hand. I told my people, you know. This statement here, as I see the Holy Spirit got me tearing, I have so much thing to say to you. But this statement here in this fifth verse, don't feel sorry for him. I go to crying a little bit. Because I really want the body of Christ to get this. When Jesus then lifted up his eyes and saw a great company come unto him, he took responsibility. And he tried to let Philip in on it. And he said unto Philip, when shall we buy bread that these may eat? Now look at verse 6. What do this mean? He knew what he gonna do. See. Huh? You think he got a word of knowledge? Huh? You think he got a word to know what's going on now? You think he have a word of wisdom to know what's gonna happen in a few minutes? You think it's possible that he was operating in these supernatural gifts? He was not just thinking of this stuff. Maybe he yield to what God had given him to overcome and supersede the natural. You know he's a man, right? The Bible says, and this he said to prove him. For he himself knew what he would do. Yes. Now watch this. Let's just ride this a little bit. Let's watch this. Philip answered him, 200 penny worth of bread is not sufficient for them, that every one of them may take a little. Nobody want no little. Right. Say it, I'm tired of taking a little. See, now, when you try to flow from the natural, you stay in the little. So Philip is letting them know there's a little into this. If you don't learn how to flow in the spirit, in your finances. So Philip made his explanation in verse 8. Here's another boy. He shot. One of the disciples answered Simon Peter's brother, said to him, there's a lad here which have five barley loaves and two small fishes. But what are they among so many? Something need to happen. See? What are they? And you recognize when you ran out, right? Huh? Anybody here ever ran out? You know what I'm talking about. I ain't talking about the gas. You know what I'm talking about. Constantly running out. Well, I'm here tonight to tell you your running out days are over. The Holy Ghost gonna say something to you in the spirit, give you an insight that you're gonna know how to make them tithes work. You're gonna know how to make those seeds work supernaturally through signs, wonders, and miracles. You're going to stop looking to the bread, the natural, what Philip talking about and what that other boy talking about, and you're going to begin to look to God as your souls and come into, you listening? Supernatural financial favor. If you ever get under that anointing, it's over. This statement not going to sound too good. It's not going to sound too kosher. I don't know how it's going to sound. You got to stop trying to make it happen. And know that it already has happened. And then let it happen. Write that down. Stop trying to make it happen. Know it has already happened. Then let it happen. There's a lad here which had five barley loaves and two small fish, but what are they among so many? Now notice Jesus in verse 10. Notice Jesus. Notice what Jesus said. Pay no attention. No attention to natural resources. He knew he could shift gear. You must know that you can shift gear in your finances. What I said? Is anybody here tonight planning on shifting gear? I'm going to show you. Watch now. And Jesus said, make the men sit down. It sounds like a man who knew what he's going to do, right? Now there was much grass in the place, so the men sat down in a number of about 5,000. Verse 11. And Jesus took the tithe. And Jesus took the seed. Give your tithes to Jesus. Give your seed to Jesus. Who you been tithing to? Oh, the Holy Ghost is going to help me in here tonight. Yes, I'm just going to wait till I get that hot spot, but he's going to help me. Because I know you all been tired and you're not getting nothing back. You ain't getting much back. Because I've took a survey over the body of Christ. Best part of the body of Christ still broke. I mean, you know, they're faking it. Didn't you know that? But I mean, you get them behind a wall, they'll tell you the truth. But that's not what money come is all about. It's about manifestation. It is prophetically from God to take care of his children. It's for the body of Christ. Every time you pull a lever, you need to be moving another notch. There's an anointing there. And Jesus took the loaf, and when he had given thanks, he distributed it to the disciples, and the disciples to them that were set down, and likewise of the fishes as much as they would. You ought to have as much money as you would have. Tell me, I'll take that. Now, I know we got some unbelief in here. And I know we got some people listening to me and don't realize what I'm trying to do up in here. But I hope the Holy Ghost comes set in your seat with you and tell you what the man of God trying to do at the close of this camp meeting. I'm trying to start signs, wonders, and divers miracles in your finances. I'm trying to get you where you can yield to the gifts of the Spirit, that you'll know where to go, when to go, how long to stay, and things start happening to your finances supernaturally by the hand of Almighty God. I know it works. I tied a long time and wasn't receiving nothing like I should. I read about the good measure pressed down, shaking together, but I didn't have no good measure pressed down, shaking together. And living right. But the financial status was not changing much. But it changed. And I'm here to share with you as a brother. See, there's a quickening word going to come through here. I'm going to walk till it come. I'm trusting the Holy Ghost. I'm not trying to impress nobody. But I know one thing, you have to understand that signs, wonders, and divers, miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost is covenant orientated. And whatever Christ died for, that's where they'll flow. So you got to expect a sign, expect a wonder, not just a check. And you have to stop all of this ungodly marketing. Trying to make it happen yourself. Did the Holy Ghost tell you to do that? I didn't sell nothing. I didn't steal nothing. Come on, Apostle. And I baby said, I don't push tapes or nothing too much. I don't push them too much. Yes, sir. Matter of fact, what I've done is I'm sowing in you now. You can go on the line and get everything I got. Yes, sir. Thousand of sermon. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Tell me how many minutes they let you listen a little while. Yeah. And get you right in and say, they market it. Oh my God. Underline as much as they would. What kind of life that is? I mean, take it over. Don't just look at the fish. Take it over in your life. As much as they would. They up there talking about just a little. Not enough for everybody. But Jesus, miraculously, through a word of knowledge and a word of wisdom, recognized what his Father was going to do. So he announced he already knew what to do. How did he know what to do? Sam, well, you know what to do. Sam, well, you'll know how to get out the trick bag. Sam, well, you'll know how to get out scarceness and famine. Get a word from the Lord. Get a word from the Lord and stop worrying the Lord about your finances. Lord, if you don't come, we're not going to make it. I need you here by Thursday. I'm not making fun. I'm just telling you, you know, I'm just trying to tell you we got to get out of this. I know it's true. Because I'm not the only one prospering in my ministry. I watch these boys prosper. I watch them as they connect and follow. And so I watch them prosper, pass people up like they're standing still. Because something supernatural happened in their life. Oh, my goodness, Jesus. Jesus. When they were filled, he said unto his disciples, gather up the fragment that remained, that nothing be lost. Therefore, they gathered together and filled 12 baskets. He's more than enough. What I'm aiming to show you, because I'm going to show you some steps in a few minutes, but what I'm aiming to show you is that we are stuck in the rat race of normal pay. And you're not believing God enough for the supernatural. For a word, get a word on your finances. While you're praying. You ever got a word on your finances? Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Are you following me? Yes, sir. Other words, I'm talking about signs, wonders, divers, miracles, and gifts of the Holy Ghost.
Yes, sir.
Supposed to work on your finances also.
Yes, sir.
Are you hearing me?
Yes, sir.
I'm not talking about education. I'm not talking about did you graduate from college? I didn't. But I drove you on a Rolls Royce, my wife was behind me in another one. They were gifts from God supernaturally. See, God, oh my goodness. I preached for Creflo Dollar many years. He always would pick me up in a Rolls Royce. I didn't have none, and you know, I wouldn't even think about no Rolls Royce. One time he had a new black Ghost. He picked me up. No, not Ghost, it was a Phantom. He picked me up in. So I got in the back. You know, you get in the back, the guy driving you. So when I got in there, I went down to the floor and I rubbed that floor. I wasn't gassing. You know. But I just run. I want to see why, because I know it wasn't a regular floor mat.
Yeah.
So I passed my hand. When my hand hit it, the thought come in my mind that was nowhere there. Lord, do you want me to have one of these?
Yeah.
Now I'm out of my mind. One of these, I can't handle this.
Yeah.
But I made the statement,
yeah.
Not knowing. I mean, I wasn't guessing after no Rolls Royce. I could have rode in my other car, you know.
Yeah.
And then I went to see Dr. Price. I might have them mixed up. I went to see Dr. Price. I think one happened before the other one. And, you know, we was talking, and I had little buckets on the wall where you receive your offering, and my wife told on me. And Dr. Price said, that's foolishness.
Yeah.
So I didn't say nothing, you know. So I got out. I said, Dr. Price, he ain't going to tell me what to do. I know. Lord told me. I laid down on the bed. The Lord came and said, Fred, right, you wrong. But I asked him to go to see his house. I wanted to see his house. I want to see what he's working with. But I didn't know the man be bitten. I didn't know you just can't ask people to go to the house. I'm from the country, man. You know, we go to each other's house all the time. We go sit on the porch at another point in the house. And so I asked him. He said, oh, no. And by the time I got to the parking lot, he said, meet him at a certain time. I'm telling this story for a reason. So we met, we followed him to his house. Now he's a very ticky man about his stuff. I get out of the car, he in the garage. Come here. I go over there, he says, sit in this Rolls Royce so you'll know how to drive it when you get yours. You think that may have been a word? Because I had no idea about no Rolls Royce, nothing else. Because I didn't have Rolls Royce tire money. Because you don't take a Rolls Royce to the shop and think it's going to be $10,000. And they start, the Rolls Royces start showing up. God, I asked him, did he want me to have one? Then he told me how to sit, know how to sit when I get one. And coming here, I met no Rolls Royces. None. I have met one coming here. They're available. Hallelujah. So Jesus himself knew what he would do. He's working with a word of wisdom, a word of knowledge, the gift of faith, and the working of miracles. And see, now, if you're just looking at it, you just think he's just working something. You see what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
You understand what I'm saying?
Yes, sir.
Let me try to give you some help here. I feel the Holy Ghost coming on. I'm just going to talk. Just talk to, you know, the word of wisdom. There in 1 Corinthians chapter 12, they start talking about being ignorant. We better read it. That being ignorant. And nobody won't be ignorant. Anybody in here want to be ignorant? Well, you've been ignorant.
Yes,
yeah. I'm trying to get some of the ignorancy out of you tonight. That you can go and get your money. You just get hot if you want. I don't care. Just get hot. I'm trying to get you somewhere. I ain't got time to be holding your hand, rubbing your head. You need to listen to what I'm saying. You know, I ain't got no time to be putting no salve on you, talking about, you know, oh, you got to talk nice to them. No, I ain't talking nice. You want me to talk nice or you want your money? I thought that's the way it goes. 1 Corinthians chapter 12.
Yes, sir.
Now concerning spiritual gift, brethren, I would not have you ignorant. And I'm saying to a certain degree, the body of Christ is ignorant about spiritual gift concerning their finances.
Yes, sir. Yes,
sir. I wish I had three people say I'm guilty. Spiritual gifts are needed in every aspect of the premise.
Yes.
Because it's spiritual gifts that transport you into the realm of the spirit.
Yes.
Notice what it says here. You know you were Gentile carried away with these dumb idols, even as you was led, them dumb pyramids and them dumb. The last one I dealt with, apostolically, they come, they won't talk to me. No, you don't want to talk to me. You really don't want to talk to me. You think you won't talk to me. Wherefore, I give you to understand that no man speaking by the Spirit of God calleth Jesus a curse, and that no man can say that Jesus is the Lord but by the Holy Ghost. Now, let's go on through here a minute. Now, there are diversities of gift, but the same Spirit. See that?
Yes, sir.
And there are differences of administration, but the same Lord.
Yes, sir.
I won't get the two voices. And there are diverses of operation, but it is the same God who works all in all.
Yes, sir.
Look at verse 7 now.
Yes, sir. Uh-huh. Uh-huh. Yes, sir.
But the manifestation of the Spirit is given to every man to fail.
No, sir.
To profit with all. Then he gives the nine cluster, and then you go to the 11 boys. He said, but all these wicked that one in the self-same spirit divide into every man severally as he will. So you have to learn how to yield to the gifts of the Spirit, yield to signs and wonders. Do I have anybody here?
Yes, sir.
Why you get so deep on me tonight? You know I'm digging in a hole that I need to dig in. Why you want me to run and holler tonight? And I'm trying to get you somewhere. Y'all got that emotion. Y'all got that emotion pill. Listen to me. I'm drilling, not all gonna come out. Just give it a little time. See? You have to know. You see, a word of wisdom is a supernatural revelation or insight into the divine will and purpose, showing how to solve any problem that arises. Is finances in your life tonight a problem? Is there something you want you can't get? So let me give this word of wisdom again so you understand. This is a supernatural revelation or insight into the divine will and purpose, showing you how to solve any problem that may arise. We're dealing with major financial problems in the body of Christ. You don't have to say amen. Then you look at the word of knowledge. Now look at the word of knowledge. This is a supernatural revelation of divine knowledge or insight in the divine mind, will, or plan. Now that's Jeremiah 29:11. Turn there.
Yes, sir.
And also the plan of others that man could not know of himself.
Yes.
God's plan is to prosper you and give you an expected end.
Yes,
what?
Yes, sir.
And we just want to get all three of the revelation gifts of revelation. They are knowing and seeing. The discerning of spirit. This is a supernatural revelation or insight into the realm of the spirit to detect them and their plan and to read the mind.
All right.
Yeah.
Come on.
Yes, sir.
Now. All right. Now I'm going to show you. I'm going to give you some steps. I'm going to give you some steps that got me out. Now I'm out now.
Yeah, right.
You know what I did today? I wanted a Christian flag in my yard with that cross on it. So I studied what it all meant, what the cross meant, what the blue meant about the baptism, the water and baptism. The cross is the blood, and the white on that flag mean being pure, and that Jesus is faithful. And so they planted it between the two houses, but I put it a little too far. I put it about a gazebo where I could see what I'm sitting there. I won't see that flag fine, but I got to my porch and I couldn't see it, so they got to move it. Got to bring it further up so I could see when I'm sitting on the porch. Because I sat on the porch hours and hours and hours, and the rebels won't fly their flag, and everybody flying their flag. So God got a Christian flag. I'm going to fly it in their yard. When they pass my house, they're going to know Jesus did it. Now, I shared this with you somewhat. Take a seat. I shared this with you somewhat. Now, y'all going to be shocked back there because I'm walking without my Bible. To enter into the supernatural manifestation many years ago, I got my hand on five things. And the first one was, and I have scriptures to show you something. Matter of fact, turn to Jeremiah 33. The first step is, if you're going to walk into supernatural manifestation of your finances, see God as he is. And Jeremiah 33:9 give us a glimpse of what he really wants to happen in our lives. You see? And it shall be a name of joy, a praise, and an honor before all the nation of the earth, which shall hear all the good that I do unto them. And they shall fear and tremble for all the goodness and for all the prosperity that I help them with. See, now that's divine mind telling you he wanna use you as a witness of his prosperity. And then you look at Ephesians 3:20.
Yes, sir.
Now unto him that is able to do exceedingly, abundantly, above all that you ask or think, according to the power that works in us. Now that's, see God as he is. That's what God wants. God, now unto him is able to do exceed abundantly above what you ask or think. I'm in the thinking flow. If I think about something, it show up. Somebody bring it to me. I got to watch what I think about. Are you following me?
Yes.
Mark, give me 2 Corinthians 9:8 Amplified. See God as he is. 2 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 8. Y'all got Amplified, Bobby, back there? Let me see it. Nah, I'm thumbing it before it fell out. Look at this.
Yes, sir.
Look at this. And God is able to make all grace, every favor, and earthly blessing come to you in abundance. Where my money at? Where is my money? Where is my favor? Where is my abundance? Somebody help me in here. Where is it? You got to get holy mad. You got to have a holy anger. You got to recognize your father has provided for you and you not getting it. What demon blocking my money? The kingdom of heaven suffered violence. And the violence took it by force. I'm tired of seeing y'all confessing. You know, just confessing. And people, I got people been following me for years. They should have all kind of money. They should be drunk with money. See God at the end. Now those scriptures, when you read those scriptures, God wants you to prosper. Now church folk are going to talk you out of it. They got some church folks up here tonight. I see the way they're sitting and look at me. They don't understand what I'm doing. Been broke so long. Not even thinking about being rich. The blessing of the Lord, what? What else happened? Jesus became poor for what?
Yes, sir.
It's just like being in a meeting. You're teaching on finances. The man gonna get up and say, a great healing revival coming. I said, set your tail on him. We ain't talking about no healing revival. I'm trying to get these people some money now. That's part of God's redemption too. Everything got to be healing. See, the thing about money is you can't fake money.
Right.
You can't fake that. That got to show up. You can't fake it. And then let me ask you what? Why do God, if God don't want us to have it, why do he talk about money so much in the Bible? Why did when Jesus and Peter need to pay tax, Jesus had a word of knowledge and a word of wisdom and told Peter, don't get upset. Don't go in the treasure. I got this. I've heard from heaven. Go out there and the first fish you catch. How did Jesus know that money was in that fish? Through the gift of the Spirit.
Yes, sir.
God will tell you where the money is. Oh, yes, sir. He'll tell you where the money is. And he'll have when you go there, he have it ready for you. He'll minister to the person because I know it wasn't normal when Moses told those slaves to go borrow from their master. That'll get you killed, boy. That is not kosher. But Moses had a word from God that when they get there, God was going to touch them And they gave them the stuff, yes. And they left not empty-handed. Yes. Aren't you tired being empty-handed? You need a word from the Lord. Now you just tell three people I'm getting my money. Tell them. I'm gonna get my money. God want me blessed. God want my need met. God say he'll cancel all my debt. God say I'll make you the lender, not the borrower. God said I'll make you the head, not the tail. God say I'll bless you in the city and bless you in the field. God say that. But you can't do it normally. You can't do it by 40 hours. You got to have your expectancy in God. You got to tell some of your ugly family members you don't want to talk about it no more. God about to do something for me. They tell you start following a man like me or following a man like Philip or like Ron or somebody who's teaching this. They tell you, you better leave them fellow. That's the fellow you need to follow. Man. See God as he is. Yes, now this next one is very, when I first read this, take your eyes off of your circumstances. First Kings 17, she said, she only had a little. Second Kings 4:2, she said, I have not anything in the house but a little pot. But the gift of prophecy and the gift of faith and the working of miracle. That all never stopped coming till all those pot was full. Then that meal started rising up in the barrel supernaturally. The man of God has spoken a word over that those signs and wonders start taking place in that barrel. I can see signs and wonders taking place in your check account. Signs and wonders. Oh yes, expect it. See, you can't expect something you never heard. Step three. Your problem is miracle opportunities.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
That's back to John 6:6 with that word of wisdom, word of knowledge. But I want to get these to you before I close. I'm going to get these to you. Step four. Realizing every promise of God is the seed for your miracle. Oh, my. Look in Luke chapter 5. Luke, I've been toiling all night long. Some of y'all have been toiling in your finances. You're good people. You serve in the church. You love your pastor and you're doing things. But that financial thing, you're toiling with it. Yeah, Luke 5 tells us what to do. You need a word. You need a word from God. Listen. You read this story before. Huh? But did you apply the gift of the Spirit to it? See? Did you apply the gift of the Spirit to it? The gift of working of miracles took place here. The gift of working of miracles. Let's see what that gift is, man. The gift of working of miracles. Give me a minute.
Yes, sir.
Gift of working of miracles. I know that's so now. I feel the Holy Ghost. Because Jesus wants me to teach you this tonight, you know.
Yes,
he wants me to share this with you. Just hold on a minute. I'm trying to get back to these gifts. Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Almost going to ask Leroy to come find him from my own farm. No, he ain't yet. They're trying to disappear. Hold on. See, I want to deal with the working of miracle.
Yes, sir.
The working of miracle is supernatural power to intervene in the ordinary course of nature.
Yeah.
And to counteract natural laws if necessary. Let me get that again. See, you need this on your finances. Listen, it's supernatural power
right.
to intervene in the ordinary course of being broke. And to counteract natural laws if necessary.
Right. Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Wow. Now watch this. Watch this. Watch this a minute. I didn't preach this text many times, but look at this. This thing is so outstanding if you know the gifts of the Spirit are working. Yeah. See what happened? You think Jesus doing all this stuff just by faith. And so you are aiming to, you know, do your finances by faith. But you have to yield to the gifts. Do you know you're a candidate for a word of knowledge, right? Do you know God can give you a word of wisdom, right? Yeah, so don't do all the praying. Stop sometime and listen. Sometimes God can't get nothing in. There are certain surges I get when I'm praying, I stop. And then he tells me something. Luke 5 says, and it came to pass, verse 1, that as the people pressed upon him to hear the word of God, he stood by the lake of Gennesaret and saw two ships standing by the lake, but the fishermen was gone out of them and were washing their net. And he entered into one of the ships, which was Simon, and prayed him that he would thrust out a little from the land. And he sat down and taught the people out of the ship. Now when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, I mean, what this man out of his mind, what do you mean? I'm a fisherman.
Right, uh-huh.
He a preacher.
Right, yeah.
He going to try to tell me how to fish? Let me tell you something. What I'm talking about now going to take your participation. We're not talking about regular church service here. We're talking about you paying attention when you meditate in that word, when you're in your sitting in the church listening. Pay attention to what God say to you. Some of it not going to even sound right. Just write it down. Write it down and write it. Look at it over and over again. Write it. Because he's sometimes telling you a supernatural move you got to make, so it's not going to be ABC. How many with me in here? How many understand? So Jesus said in the fourth verse now, when he had left speaking, he said unto Simon, launch out in the deep and let down your net for a draw. What? I've been trying to get a draw all night long, man. And Simon answered and said to him, Master, we have toiled all the night and have taken nothing. Now, do you know that Sam Jesus is talking to you tonight?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
Now, nevertheless, at thy word, I will let down the net. Nothing happened. Nothing happened. But it says, and when they had this done. That is all out of the sense realm.
Right. Yeah.
It don't make no sense.
Right.
You know, you can fish all night long. You know how the fishes work. You're a professional fisherman. It don't make no sense a man tell me to go back in the same water with the same fish in the same boat. It just don't make no sense. And that's where you got to come to the point. It don't have to make sense. And when they had this done, they enclosed a great multitude of fish and their net break. Just following a divine instruction. I said just a supernatural power to intervene in the ordinary course of nature and to counteract natural laws if necessary.
Wow.
My God. Step 5. Plant a miracle seed. Act on God's word. 1 Kings 17, the widow did. Her house did eat many days. 2 Kings 4, 5, 7. She and her son went and did what he said. She went and paid off the creditors. He had enough to pay her bills in 2 Kings chapter 4. Are you following me?
Yes,
now, I got to find a jumping off place here. They didn't give me 15 minutes. I might not take them. Let's go to Ruth for a minute. Ruth.
Yes, sir.
Book of Ruth, just for a minute.
I'll
know when I'm finished.
Yes, sir.
I had to do nothing tonight. I didn't preach hard this week anyway.
Yes, sir. Wow.
Yep. You've been blessed. What?
Yes, sir.
If you didn't, you wasn't here.
Yes,
and them boys done preach too. Them boys preach, man.
Yes, sir.
What?
Yes,
sir. Did they preach?
Yes. Wow.
Make a daddy proud.
Yes,
sir. No, I ain't wasting my time. They don't never change. I ain't wasting my time. How many of y'all know all the books of the Bible? Well, anybody raise their hand? Let me ask them how much money they got. Ruth chapter 2. And Naomi had a kinsman of her husband, a mighty man of wealth, of the family of Elimelech, and his name was Boaz. Naomi threw the gift of prophecy there in Ruth 3:1. Turn that with me. Then Naomi, her mother-in-law, said unto her, "My daughter, I shall seek rest for thee, that it be well with thee." And then if you look in 2:12,
yes, sir.
The Lord recompense you for what you have done, and a full reward be given to you by the Lord, the God of Israel, under whom wing you have come to take refuge.
Yes, sir.
And then if you look in the 3rd chapter, 13th verse, so Boaz took Ruth, and she was his wife. She became rich. She married a wealthy man. Supernatural. Naomi knew what to tell her. Y'all hear?
Yes, sir.
Then the gift of prophecy in 2 Chronicles chapter 14, verse 17, chapter 20, 14, 17, Jehaziel, the prophet. He said, a gift of prophecy, a gift of wisdom, the gift of knowledge, the gift of faith. He said, you should not need to fight in this battle.
Yes, sir.
Then you get to 2 Chronicles 20:20. You know what that say, right?
Yes, sir.
Jehoshaphat stood and said, "Hear me, O Judah. Believe in the Lord your God, so you shall be established. Believe his prophet, so shall you prosper."
Yes,
what happened? Look at the 20th verse, 25th verse. Turn to 2 Chronicles 20:25. Look like nothing going to work. And you're finding, how your finance look now? Like nothing working. That's you in a good spot.
Yep.
To hear a message like this.
Yes, sir.
Look at everybody against you. And people are calling. I remember you used to be calling. You're two nose behind.
Yeah.
Take the phone off the hook a while. I'm tired. But notice here. Notice. My goodness. Look at that 25th verse. 25th verse. All they had to do was praise him. The man prophesied. Gave them a word. And it was going into a wealth transfer and didn't know it. Sometimes your enemy drives you into a wealth transfer. Because you know what? God said, "I'm tired of them messing with my child. I'm about to show them something. I'm about to bring them out of debt. I'm about to bless them like they've never been blessed before." You keep touching God's child, God going to rise them up. Many preachers tried to hold me down. Cut me off from their pulpit. God rose me up on the other side. When they got to acting foolish over there, God moved me somewhere else. God moved me so much, they said, "Where is he?" Say he's flying in a Falcon 900B.
Yeah.
He a little higher than you in your prop plan. He just passed over you. God is about to do something in your life like never before. I just try to tell you a few things tonight, but I believe God is working in your life. Just go ahead and receive it. Start studying those gifts. Start yielding to those gifts. Stop looking for just a natural way. Yield to the supernatural. Praise God for what you heard tonight. Expect supernatural manifestation in your finances. Matter of fact, I'm speaking on you tonight. I tell you, we'll pull tonight. We'll pull on the basis that money cometh is supernatural. And that you're going to yield to the gifts of the Spirit. And you're going to let the gifts of the Spirit show you your way out. Keep tithing. Keep sowing. But keep watching. Stop trying the natural kind of way. The Spirit of God, there's so many things. I got notes, but there's so many things. But that's enough tonight. Tell somebody you're about to get it. Tell them this is not no play stuff. This already been proven, tell them. This is a word from God. Money coming to me now. You have to say it like you own it. You got to put some boldness. You got to put some spark in. You got to say it. You got to expect something to happen. Something stirring in the air right now. Every time we pull, money go to move. One time the Lord told me, he said, when we pull like that, all the money in the bank start moving. All the money in the world start moving. Money coming to me now. Yeah, it is right here. See, on that third pull, something gonna break loose up in here. On that third pull, your money gonna be found. Your door gonna come open. Your gate gonna come open. You got to believe it though. I'm not gonna pull until I feel some belief in here. You gotta believe this come from God. You gotta believe this not a man. This has been proven already. He paid his church off. He paid his RV off. He bought a new pool to broadcast. He got a $345,000 RV. That's a house, man. 600 acres of land you're paid for. Church paid for. Everything you see paid for. All them Rolls Royces I'm driving, they're paid for. Have no note, no credit. Oh, nobody, nothing. God did it. Tell somebody God did it. God about to do it for you. Because he's no respecter of person. When we pull this time, expect all your finances to change. Then when we pull this time, somebody got to shout in here. Shout like they're out of debt. Shout like all their needs met. Shout like there's a breakthrough right now. Money coming to me now. Shout. All right. revelation never lose filled and never loses the anointing. God, people recognize it. He told me it will never, see, it's an end time word. Money coming is to Jesus, one of the spot rankers that we have to get out of the church for Jesus to come back. But I've seen it for 27 years. Every time God's people pull, they get a notion to give, they start giving. See how they start sowing? Start sowing. But something get a hold of you. It just blesses God's people. You know, I just in the supermarket, man, I was minding my own business. And God gave me this revelation of money coming. I didn't even know what I had. I went home and told my wife. Then some years later, I go to a large convention, and the son comes and says his dad wanted me to preach at 2 o'clock. I wasn't supposed to be a speaker. I go back to the hotel and start praying. And then I get up and tell this story about I went to the supermarket. And I was behind that man with the 8-pack of beer. And a little short white man. So he went in his wallet to pay for his bill. And I saw when he got it back, it wasn't much change. I saw in his wallet, he ain't had nothing in there either. And he turned around and told me, he said, money really going. I mean, that's normal talk, man. I said, yeah. When I got in the car, God asked me, what you said in that car? What you said in that store? I said, Lord, I didn't say anything. But I found out if you agree with somebody, it's just like you saying it. And so when I am to tell God what was said in that store, when I got the prefix out, when I got the prefix out of goit, I received wrong, of goit, I heard right here. Look up here, because this will help you. I heard money coming. And I had never heard those two words before. Money coming. Had you ever heard that? Money coming. Then it hit a second time. The third time I heard it, something broke loose in me. Okay? So now I go back to the meeting now. They asked me to preach. So I start telling this story. And I had the audacity to say this would be the largest offering in this 20-year camp meeting at a 2 o'clock service. When I start telling the story, hundreds of people got up. I know I ain't called no altar call or nothing. They headed my way, and then they got clothes. I saw they had money in their hand. And they laid it on the altar. That's my, new to me. I didn't know what it was. That's my first time seeing it. And they called me and they told me it's the largest offering at a 2 o'clock service. So I got talking to my wife. I hadn't preached on anything, had I? Nope. I got talking to my wife, so I said, I'm going to preach a few days on it and see what come out. Yeah. Well, it ended up being 2 weeks. That's where the book Money Coming come from. And then supernatural finances start flowing. I would pull and say money coming, and supernatural finances start flowing, and then I get report from other people things start happening in their lives. Because of this revelation. It's for the body of Christ. So you say it, money coming. Now I taught them young man, I taught y'all something, but most of the body of Christ turned it loose. So you can't be turning it still loose. I told you when you write a check, write on top of your name, write money coming. I didn't tell you go get no checks run out typed with money coming on it. I told you write it. You got to follow instruction. See, your writing it is the thing going to activate it. Not reading it, writing it. And you write it right above your name. The Lord told me, say, now, when your checks go through the bank, the teller's going to be money coming, Leroy Thompson. See, they're confessing money in my account. So begin to write on your checks again. When you sign your check, write money coming. I know some people never stop. Keep on doing it. Once I tell you something, keep on doing it. Now, you know I have a track record for this. I've been a millionaire a long time, and on a few million. You understand? The word works. It works. But he gave me the example to the body of Christ. I can preach it because it manifested in my life. Now, you probably never thought about being a millionaire. But it got 300 in here. You got 300. I receive that. You got 300 in here. It's going to take a while. Take a while. But you got to connect and stay connected. Stay connected. Them boys, they're on their way. You're looking at millionaire pastors. You can't keep following me. You can't keep following me. Keep sowing in me and nothing happen. You understand me? My friend, you understand me?
Yes, sir.
You understand what I was aiming to do tonight, minister to you some and give you some information?
Yes, sir.
You understand that?
Yes, sir.
That when you go home, you'll have some meat on your table. You understand what I'm saying? Huh?
Yes,
you understand that I'm saying to you that it's not just by labor. I receive, sir. Yes, sir. Money coming. It's not just by labor. It's by faith.
Yes.
Labor money will never stand with favor money. So I pronounce financial favor on every person in this room. Do you receive it? On ministries, I pronounce financial favor upon every minister in this room. Every church that respected me enough to come and stay all the week, I release my anointing on. Every member of the church, you came with your pastor, I release a financial anointing on your life. Now. You don't have to know how. All you need to know is why. Tell three people I have a fresh financial anointing on me. Fresh. Find four more people and tell them. I have a fresh financial anointing on me, I receive. Tell them, find them. I receive. Find them. I receive, you see. Receive. I have a fresh financial anointing on me. I have a fresh financial anointing on me. Right here, right now. What you have? A fresh what? It's on you now?
Fresh.
Financial anointing. Find five more people and tell them. You just got to work this thing till the Holy Ghost turn on loose. I receive it. Yes, sir. It's on you. Yes, my friend. Yes. Work until it hit. You have a fresh financial anointing. I receive. Work until it hit. Find five more people. Work until it hit. It's about to hit in here. That anointing about to hit in here. Almost here. I have a fresh financial anointing on me. Find somebody else. Tell them until it hit. I have a fresh financial anointing on me. I'll never be the same. My finances will never be the same. I have a fresh financial anointing on me now. Tell somebody. Find somebody else and tell them. Tell them I got a fresh. Go tell somebody. Go tell it. A fresh. Go ahead, girl. I receive. Good to see you, man. You know what? You get in the spirit realm, and God, people go to moving sometime, you don't know what to do, right? But I got instruction for you.
Yes, sir.
Go back and get your notepad and write the date and the time you received this anointing. And I want you to track it. Write the date, the time, and I want you to track it and see what started happening in your finances. Either I'm a man of God or I'm a false prophet. See, a fresh anointing. You have a fresh anointing. Now you know how to yield to the gifts of the Spirit. You know how to be led by the Spirit in your finances. And nobody's going to talk to you on a quick deal. And nobody's going to talk to you on a quick seed. You got 30 seconds to sow it. Don't send nothing. In that. Write this date down at 2017 camp meeting. I receive a fresh financial anointing. Now listen, children. When you're moving in the spirit, you don't know exactly sometimes where God taking you. But we got there to that fresh anointing. Sometimes it's one word, sometimes it's two words. But he, all the while I was teaching, he's working on something. But I saw the respond. And that's what he was aiming to do tonight. Put a fresh anointing on you for finances. Do you have it? I write it down. Write down the date and everything. I receive a fresh anointing. And start seeing what start happening. Now you have to be alert to the spirit. But I think some phenomenal things are going to happen. You're going back home with a fresh... And, you know, you got it from a man who's freshly anointed. And I wouldn't play no games with you. No, that a genuine, fresh anointing, a fresh financial anointing.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
I don't know. I may have said it sometime, these boys follow me. But this fresh financial anointing, you know, the Bible talked about in the 92nd Psalm about a fresh anointing, you know. But it's a fresh financial anointing. That means that the Holy Spirit is going to be giving you a divine ability to function in finances like you never functioned before. How many of y'all believe the Holy Spirit know what to do? We never give the Holy Spirit a chance because religion taught us that the Holy Spirit don't have nothing to do with that. When he said, men is led by the Spirit of God. Huh? He can, Holy Spirit,
lead me
in my finances.
In my finances.
See, you think about being led by the Spirit, Romans 8:14. You think the Holy Spirit just leading you to church. See, but he has so many promises about finances to God's children that, all right, you got a fresh anointing. I'm about to give you another secret now. Got a fresh anointing. Now, from this night forward, be led by the Spirit in your finances. So you got a fresh anointing. Now you're going to give the Holy Spirit in charge of your finances. Say it, Holy Spirit.
Holy Spirit,
you are in charge,
of my finances.
Oh, boy, you shouldn't have said that. If you said that and you meant that, and I believe you meant it, you got a fresh anointing. Now you're going to be led by the Spirit in your finances. You're going to yield to the gifts of the Spirit. It's a whole new ball game. See, because we have thought just by paying tithe they're going to make it happen. But it didn't make it happen. See, when you pay your tithe now, you're in a position for the Holy Spirit to lead you. And some of the most unlikely, now I didn't say ungodly, unlikely ways, God will bless you financially. See, I do not wear a fake financial anointing. I wear a fixed financial anointing And it will work, and then you can't release it all the time. But tonight, because of your patience all the weekend, because of I just taught you tonight, all of a sudden God, fresh anointing, fresh financial anointing. Then he says, now put the Holy Ghost in charge of your finances. Stop worrying yourself. Then be led by the Spirit in your finances. All right?
Yes,
all right, let's sow your first seed, knowing that. See, we got to write something on this seed. Let me see what we're going to write. We got to, fresh anointing on your fire. We got to write something on this seed. Right on that envelope, thank you, God, for my fresh financial anointing. Write it on there. Thank you, God, that's $500 for my fresh, put that on the envelope. Thank you, God, for my fresh financial anointing. You got the date down. I told you to write the date down. This is no plaything. Word of knowledge, word of wisdom, discerning of spirit, special faith, working of miracles, gifts of healing, prophecy, divers kind of tongue, interpretation is on my finances. Whoa, man. The nine gifts of the Spirit are on my finances. I'm led by the Spirit. I got a fresh anointing. The Holy Spirit is in charge of my finances. That's a sermon right there. Holy Spirit in charge of my finances. I got a fresh anointing. I'm led by the Spirit. And I got the nine gifts of the Spirit working on my finances. You think you can't get no money with that? All that? See, it's a place where we fully have not known that the Holy Spirit is concerned. Holy Spirit, money. Holy Spirit, money. You say, you can't do it. You can't do that. Yes, you can.
Yes, sir.
Because the Holy Spirit will do whatever the Word of God says. Who you think told Jesus where that money was in that fish mouth? The Holy Spirit. That's why Jesus said, anointing the Lord to preach the gospel to the poor. Holy Spirit, who anointed him? Acts 10:38. How God anointed Jesus of Nazareth with the Holy Ghost and power, who went about doing good and healing all who was oppressed of the devil. Listen, oppression is just not sickness and disease. That's financial oppression. You got your envelope?
Yes, sir.
What I told you to write on it?
Thank you.
All right. And you got all them old words in the trash can. You got two texts say, I'm not inferior. You got your heart clean. You had a broken heart. The boy, clean your heart up with the word of God. The other boy talked about not being, don't be dishonest no more. A lot of them brought me some checks there, but I'm forgive me, Dan. They brought me, I got some checks here tonight, and then they forgive me, and from the message. Let's do this. Camp meeting do not have to come to an end tonight. You take it with you. Go over those messages until they get down on the inside of you. Everybody ready or y'all still writing? Why them two sisters at? Dressed alike all the time. What, are they here? They left? They here? Anybody see them? They wasn't here tonight. They must have left. What, are they from New York?
California.
They might, Oakland, California. I didn't get a chance to meet them there. They was here this morning, wasn't it? Boy, they gonna hear I was looking for them tonight. God darn, I told you, girl, we shouldn't have left. Stand on your feet. Let's do this. Now you're sowing from your fresh anointing. You're going to tithe in your church Sunday from a fresh anointing. I want testimonies to come in. You either send them here or send them to Tracy. But we need to get these testimonies of financial experience. I had, you know, I told a story about the woman who had gave me $5. Then she gave me a $10 check, said she had to catch it by Monday. $10 check. Had to be caught, you know. You know what I mean, a caught. You know what I mean, caught? Yeah. Catch it before it bounced. Because it's got some check in ricochet. My secretary would be jumping all across the table trying to stop it. He'd jump, back, boom. Very few. I'll just tell the truth. Hundreds of thousands of dollars come in here, but very few. And then the people are honest. They come get it, you know. And, you know, you keep sending it back. How many times, how much it costs each time you send it? They call, man, I'll call you and tell them, hold that check. $35 every time I send it through? Now, what I was about to tell you something else, what I was talking about. Huh? Yeah. If I had catch $10 check, so she called the bank to get it lined up. She's going to, you know, go try to catch the check. And they said, ma'am, you got $14,000 in here. She don't know where it come from. Wouldn't you like to check your account and it has $14,000 you don't know nothing about? Now, that happened one time to me. That many times I've had people walk up and tell me stories like that. I remember sometime Carol and I, we had money in the bank, we don't know where it came from. We waited, see somebody gonna claim it, but they got such a lack of time to claim it. Didn't they? And we got, God, I mean, God had to put it in there. See? So you have so many ways to do it. Understand? All right, raise it up with this fresh anointing now. I'm not gonna just be tithing and just sowing seed. So I need to get a harvest. I need. Oh yeah, yeah, yeah. And I'm speaking harvest over you right now. Matter of fact, you know, every seed you planted, I prophesied a hundredfold return. I never heard it before, but it came in my heart. What did God say? I lack the life I live. Living a good life? Huh? I like living this kind of life. The best of life. And then she get out and say, living in the overflow. I prophesy that you will begin to live in the overflow. You all have sown some seed here this week. Y'all sowing, everybody get up. When people sit down, y'all still sowing. So you do. Was you sowing in an anointed meeting, in anointed men, anointed ministry? So Father, in the name of the Lord Jesus Christ, I speak harvest over these seed. I speak the 100-fold harvest over these seed. And I thank you that money will come into accounts that we cannot explain. We thank you for it. We praise you for it. Thank you for this camp meeting. Thank you for this year. We give you the glory and honor. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, when you drop it in the bucket, say, money cometh, because I got a fresh anointing on me. Watch what I'm going to, watch me. Watch me. Money cometh to me because I have a fresh financial anointing on me. Now, we ain't got time to wait on you that long, so say it fast, what are you going to say? It'll be all night. All your, let me talk to the bucket. No, say it fast. Fresh anointing. Say fresh anointing. Fresh financial anointing. You been blessed? Man, you all have had some type of fellowship. I mean, the order, all these people, the order we've had. We've had the balcony for the order. it's amazing. It's wonderful. I've been to a lot of conventions, you know. I've been to some confused and broke conventions. Y'all tell me when you're finished, boys. What?